thank you for bringing up this issue of right discourse in the youth, because it gave me an opportunity to really appreciate the whole phenomena of polarization itself. You know, we constantly talk about living in an increasingly polarized world and how it's not just happening in India, but also globally. But I don't think we've dwelled enough on why this is happening. And also, is this all bad? So, you know, there's enough research to support it when you start reading about it, that polarization in itself can be good. And when I say it can be good, it means in terms of engaging with not just voters, but any kind of audience that you want to engage with. Polarization, I feel, is a consequence of, you know, the varied levels of information that we get today. There's all kinds of political news floating around. There's, you know, the internet and the, you know, just the divergent opinions that you're able to consume all through the day, whether it's through social media or it's through print media or electronic media, and the kind of debates that you're able to witness, it's bound to make you feel more strongly about issues. Ideological divisions are becoming stronger, which means people feel that it's important to take a political stance, whereas earlier it was so easy to be a fence sitter. I don't think that's a bad thing. You know, you can be overwhelmed by all this information, or you can choose where you're leaning towards. And I think when I compare apathy to having an ideology and an opinion, I would take having an opinion either ways. So I think I look at it as somebody who's active in politics and, you know, being the only political actor in this panel, I look at it as an opportunity to strike a conversation. For me, this when I read this topic, it was not about the left and right binary, because like Anand, I believe there is the only discourse is the right discourse. So I feel as a young political actor, I see in it an opportunity to communicate. I am the ambassador of the right discourse. I represent the right discourse. It is upon me, it is my duty, in fact, I would go on to say, to make sure that the millennials understand this too. When Shubhrashtra said that there's not enough text, there's not enough body of knowledge that has been created around it, I see in it an opportunity to do just that as a political actor. And all of us are doing it in our capacities. So what I feel is that we need to create platforms. We need to constantly work towards explaining to these millennials how the very ideology that we espouse, the you know, the word Hindutva that has been associated with us. And as a 30-something year old, I'm proud that that word is associated with me. But it also makes me responsible for explaining to these 18, 17, 20-year-olds, you know, my cousin who's studying in the Delhi University and who went on to Shaheen Bagh to join the protest, you know, it is upon me to make sure that she understands where I'm coming from. It's upon me to make sure she understands that the word Hindutva is about Bandhu Bhav. It's all encompassing. It's about inclusion. Because that's the only, there is no other way I would describe Hindutva. So I think, keeping it really brief, I look at this as an opportunity, as an opening, and it increases my responsibility as a political actor that I need to explain this and explain this without shouting. I need to explain this without being jarring, not shouting at them and not amongst ourselves. You know, we're not a pack of wolves. I read something beautiful on Twitter the other day. I think Saket Suresh ji, you know, I love his writing. And he had said that, you know, the right wing is not a pack of wolves. We don't howl in unison. We're all mighty lions and we are singing our all, you know, roaring in our all different tunes. I think we need to respect that, but we need to also make sure that there's no otherization. We need to make sure that this inclusion, which forms the very fundamental of everything that we do, this needs to be communicated in the right way. Thank you.
Thank you, Abhinav.